गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. टुडे इज आवर टॉपिक इज बैंकिंग मार्केट एंड बैंकिंग. ऑलराइट, नाउ व्हाट इज बैंकिंग मार्केट और व्हाट इज बैंकिंग, फर्स्ट वी विल एक्सप्लेन दैट थिंग टू यू. ऑलराइट, सो द फर्स्ट थिंग इज व्हाट इज बेसिकली द मीनिंग ऑफ बैंकिंग. बैंकिंग इज अ बिजनेस. इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ बिजनेस वेयर अ बैंक वेयर अ पर्सन डिपॉजिट्स हिज और हर मनी in the bank which is used by a bank for lending purposes. There are two things, two main important things that you have to keep in mind. First is that there should be some deposits, all right, and second is that that deposit is given to a person who needs it in the form of loan and which is called lending. All right, so business of banker is to obtain deposits of money which is used for lending that generate profits. So why banks give you loan? So the main question arises, why banks give you loan? Banks give you loan to earn profits. And how that profit is earned? It is earned in the form of, you must have heard it. What is this called? Yes, it is called interest. So that is why banking business is called a business, because there is a profit motive behind it. Now we'll come to the structure of banking sector in India. So in India there are two types of banks. One is a scheduled bank and another is non-scheduled banks. First we'll talk about scheduled banks. Scheduled banks are further divided into two parts, that is cooperative banks and commercial banks. Can anybody tell me what is a cooperative bank? Anybody? Cooperative bank? Cooperative banks basically are made to help somebody. For example, there are producer cooperative banks, consumer cooperative banks. These are basically government banks which are run to support the state or the central areas or agricultural areas. All right, basically your whole economy is built on the cooperative bank. Then is your commercial bank. What is a commercial bank? The main motive of commercial bank. From the word commercial, you can understand that commercial bank is basically built to generate profits and commercial purposes. All the kind of loans, lendings that are done with the sole motive of earning profit are known as commercial banks. But in commercial banks, there are four types of banking systems. One is public sector banks, another is private sector bank, then is your regional rural bank, and then foreign bank. Public sector banks, the banks which are governed by the government, which is under the control of government, that is known as a public sector bank. Then is your private sector. Any example of public sector bank? Any example of public sector bank? SBI, good. And public sector banks are divided into two parts, SBIs, all the SBIs in India. Earlier, they are being named differently. For example, State Bank of Patiala, State Bank of Ludhiana and all. But now, all the state banks are merged into one bank, that is SBI, and that is State Bank of India. Then our nationalized bank, PNBs, Punjab National Banks, Bank of Baroda, all the other government banks comes under the nationalized banks of India. Then comes our private sector banks, private sector banks are also commercial banks, but they are operated privately in the economy. For example, Axis Bank, HDFC Bank, and any other example? There are so many banks. Yes, Yash, you want to say something? Yes, ICICI Bank and Kotak Mahindra. There are lots.